Good morning, namaste to all. Due to the coronavirus, all the schools, colleges, universities are closed. All the students are staying at their home. In this condition, Siddharth Shishu Sadan has organized the virtual classes for the student, and being a coordinator of this program, I like to thank dynamic teachers team, supported parents, all well wishers, and I also like to thank Mr. Vishnu Kumar sir, who is a founder of the Times Television, because this program is broadcasting on Times Television, and he has supported us a lot for this program. And now this is Mr. Raju Yadav, maths teacher of Siddharth Shishu Sadan, and today I came here to teach the mathematics. And as you know, my dear student, arithmetic, algebra, geometry, trigonometry, these are the major branches of the mathematics for secondary level, for school level. And today I will start the geometry. So let's start. And one thing I like to suggest, because one mathematician has said, when we people sit to study the maths, then we must have books, pen and paper where we will write, that means copies. And I hope you must have all these things that I have told you. So okay, let's start about the geometry. And geometry, this contain one is geo, and other word is that metron. That means geo and metron differ, and it means geo means land or earth, metron means measurement. That means in ancient time, when the people were not civilized, then they were using the concept of the geometry to measure the land. And that time they were using, but not knowingly, unknowingly they were using, because all the part of the geometry that time, it was not in systematical form. And one great Greek mathematician whose name is that Euclid. In that time, when people were not civilized, that time he had collected all the known and unknown information about the geometry, and he had written a one book. That book's name was that time Element, and that book contained 13 volumes. When that books were published, then all over the world people were started to accept, and now at present we are also following the concept of the geometry, which is given by, that is Euclid, and that's why Euclid is called the father of the geometry, because first time he had studied about the concept of the geometry. First time he had invented the concept of the geometry, and that's why he is called father of the geometry. So now Euclid, he is called still at present father of the geometry. So is it clear, Sten? So geometry means the geo plus metron, and geo means that is a length, land and earth, and the geometry was used to measure the land, and the metron means that is a measurement, that is a noun. And now we'll start the what is the meaning of the geometry. So let's see on the board. Geometry, how we define a geometry? Geometry, jyamiti, or in Nepal it is also called rekha ganit. So geometry means it is a branch of mathematics. It is a branch of mathematics which deals with relationship measurement and properties of points, lines, angles, surface and solids. It is. So the meaning of the geometry, or the definition of the geometry, is that it is a branch of mathematics. As I have just told you, arithmetic, algebra, geometry, trigonometry, all these are the major branches of the mathematics for the secondary level. In higher classes, we will study about the calculus also. So now, the concept of the geometry, that is the definition of the geometry, is that it is a branch of mathematics which deals with relationship, measurement and property of the points, lines, angles, surface and solid, etc. That means points means, now we'll discuss what is the meaning of point about the line. That means one example I just let me to take here. Now here is a b c is a triangle here. Now see, A, B, C, they are points. This A, B, A, C, B, C, these are the lines or sides. And this, this and this, these are the points. That means in this triangle, there is a relation of the points, lines, angles. And this is the, this white board is the example of the surface. And the solid, we will study about the solid also, how to find the surface area of the solid. It is based on the geometry. We can take example of the cone, cylinder, pyramid. All these are the example of the solid. And we have to find, that is how you find the surface area of the solid. And it is the base of the geometry. That's why geometry concerned with the relationship, measurement and property of the points, lines, angles, surface, solid and so more. So is it clear? What is the meaning of the geometry? Geometry means it is a branch of the mathematics which deals, which concerns with the relationship of points, lines, angle, surface, solid and more, about the more than more. So is it clear? Okay. Now, for your syllabus, in your syllabus, there is given, if you have a book, you can check your book. Now, you have to study. Number one, about the points. Number two, about the lines. Number three, about the rays. Number four, about the line segment. Number five, angles. That means in your syllabus, now your syllabus is going to be started, and we have to study about the what is the meaning of point, line, rays, line segment and angle. So let's start our syllabus. Number one is here, point. Point. Point means in Nepali we can say it is a bindu. So what is the definition? What is the meaning of the point in geometry? So point means it is a exact location. Location is position. In Nepal you can say sthan. So point means it is a exact location that has no sides. That is no length no width and no depth or height. It is shown by dot. Is represented by capital letter. Now, so point, let's take example of a dot. Now you know that the tip of a needle, the sharpened point of the pencil, the portion of the nib of a pen, and this portion of the marker. Now, suppose here is a, this is a x-axis and this is a y-axis. So now this is a dot. Here is a dot, here is a dot, here is a dot, here is a dot, here so many dots, and all these dots represent points. That means, so it is shown by dot. Now see, just I have taken an example. And it is represented by capital letter. That means we can write here, for example, we can write point A. Point A. That means in short form we can write like this. Now point P. We can write the point P here. P. Now, for example, coordinate is given 2 comma 3 here. How will you represent it? How will you find the location or position of the coordinate 2, 3. 2 is a what is a abscissa and 3 is a what is a ordinate. For example, 1, 2, and here is a 1, 2, 3. Suppose the coordinate 2, 3. Now it is a position, it is a location of the point 2, 3. Here, this point. That means this point it can't move this side, that side, or this side, it can't move. So that it is called, it has a no size. That means no dimension. So, my dear student, how do you define a point? What is the meaning of point? So, point means it is a, in geometry, it is a location, fixed location, and it doesn't have length, breadth, height. That means no dimension, zero dimension. And I have shown the example, and it is represented by dot. I have taken the, this is a dot, it is also the point. The portion of the pencil I have told, the portion of a nib of pen I have told. That means all these are the example of dot or point. Now, one more example can take. Suppose province number 2, do you know the Pradesh number 2, 3? Now suppose we have to represent the province number 2. We have to locate the province number 2 in a map of our country. For example, this is a board, and this board is the suppose example of our map of our country, and we have to represent, we have to locate the position, or the position of the province number 2. Suppose this board, and here is a, suppose this is a map of our country, Nepal. Suppose here is a province number 2. And now we can write here, we can represent a dot or a point. I suppose that province number 2, I am taking a letter, capital letter, that is a P. So now this point P represent the position or location of the province number 2 in map of our country. So this is the explanation of the point. Okay, so once more, it is the exact location is what is the position that has no size, that means zero dimension, no length, no width, no height, and it is represented by the single capital letter. I have shown here, we can take the point x, y, z, any. Okay, and I have taken the example of the point or the dot is that is, as you know, the tip of a needle, the portion of a nib of a pen, the portion of the pencil. There are so many examples are here. So now, number one about the point, it is a finish. Now let's discuss about the number two is here. Lines or line, rekha. In Nepali, it is called rekha. So, what is the meaning? What is the definition of line in a geometry? Because in definition, the line that is the main foundation of the geometry, base of the geometry. So, what is the meaning of a line? Now, the definition of a line is that it is a set of the points. It is a set of the points, or we can also say locus of the points. Locus means bindu path. बिंदु पथ मीन्स पॉइंट हरु द्वारा बनाइएको पथ, बनाइएको बाटो, दैट इज अ लोकस. सो इट इज अ सेट ऑफ द पॉइंट्स, दैट इज लाइन. दैट मीन्स लाइन, इट इज अ सेट ऑफ द पॉइंट और दैट इज लोकस ऑफ द पॉइंट्स दैट that extends infinitely in both direction. Now I will give you an example also, how the set of the point is called a line. I will explain here. So it is a set of the point or locus of the point that extend infinitely in both direction. It is represented by capital letter or small letter also. Now it is a set of the points. See the example. Now see, this is the set of the points. We have taken the so many points in a plane and all the points are connected. Then there is a form, a line, and here is a that extends infinitely in both directions. That means this line, see this arrow represent this line. Line means the all the many many points are connected. That means this is a path traced out by the points. That is, it is called the locus of the points also. That means this line, this side or that side in infinitely way can be extended. That means like etta pani badhati badhauna sakinchha, etta pani jati badhauna sakinchha. That means suppose here is a AB. If the capital letter it will take, then we can write here line AB, or we can write line AB in this way also. That means here the our arrow head in both sides. That means now AB, line AB, it doesn't have a fixed length. No, that means it can be extended in both directions. That means we can say in short form, no ending points. This means this side also, the point A and B are not end point or not fixed point. That's why you can take another example. Suppose here is another, this is a, and it is represented by small letter P. Then we can write line P. We can write there line P. And here also both side is arrow. That means no ending point. That means, let's see once more. It is a set of the points. That means there is point how connect bhayera jo geometrical tota object form huncha, that is called kere line. And line means this line can be both point, both side it can be extended. That means that extend in infinitely in both direction. That means in both side no ending point. Is it clear? So now this is an example, A and B, the capital letter, and it can be represented by the single small letter also. Now this is the example of a definition and the example of line. Number three, there is a ray. Number three is here ray. So what is the meaning of ray here? Ray means kiran, point means bindu, line means rekha, or ray means Kira. Now, so what is the meaning of re? So one example I like to show here. Suppose here is a sun, S-E-N, sun. And rays, see, rays will go that side, this side, no? And rays, it will go in any direction. That means the starting point of a ray is here. That it is a fixed. But the rays of the sun, where it will be indeed, it is not fixed. That's why ray means we can write, definition of a ray we can write, ray is a part of the line. Ray is a part of the line having one end point that extends infinitely infinitely in one direction only. See, ray is a part of the line having one end point that extends infinitely in one direction only. Now we can take example. Now here is a, see, now here is example. Suppose A and here is a B. AB is a ray and A is a, what is a? A is a fixed. One end point is here. That means A is a fixed point. And B, it is not a fixed point. That means AP can be extended infinitely in that direction. But this ray AB, it cannot be extended in this direction because C, it is an end point. It is a fixed point. But the point B is not fixed. The one side is arrow, the another, and we can write here, it is represented by capital letters, Now we can take the another example here. Suppose P and here Q. Now see, now here P is the end point and Q is the direction. So PQ we can write here. Now ray AB or AB over, if that is an arrowhead in one direction. That means A is a fixed and B is the direction. In same way, we can write here, that is the PQ, ray PQ, that means P is the base, B is the endpoint, and the Q represent the direction. So, this is the meaning of a ray. That means, what is the difference between line and ray? Line means no ending point. Ray means there is a one ending point. The major difference is there. So we could finish point also, about the line also, about the ray also, and we are going to start about the line segment. Okay, so about the line segment, we'll start the point number 4 about the line segment. About the number 4, line segment. We can say line segment means Rekha Khand. Line and segment means that is a Khand, Rekha Khand. So how we define it is a piece or part, piece or part of the line having two end points. It is represented by capital letters. Now see, here is a AB. See, it is a piece or part of the line having two end points. That means A and B both are the end point. That means this line segment, it cannot be extended either this side or that side also. So here is the both points are the end points. Now suppose here is a, now this is a CD. So C and D, these two are the fixed or the end points that cannot be extended in any direction. So many examples can take here, that is a X and a Y. This is also the line segment. We can write here, that is a line short form, line segment AB. Here is a line segment, what is a CD? Here is a line segment, what is a XY? Then no arrow. That means here is a line over the AB, CD, and XY. That means no arrow head. No arrow means it cannot be extended. So, right? It is the meaning of the line segment. So, now number five is an angles, but before starting the angle, I like to give the concept about the parallel lines and about the perpendicular lines. Then we'll start the angles. Okay, now so let's see on the board. Look at on the board number, here is not given about the parallel and the perpendicular lines in the 6 number 7 number. But I like to start the parallel lines. Now, here, what is the meaning of parallel lines? Parallel lines. What is the meaning of parallel lines? Okay. So, now I am going to rub the definition of the line segment. Now, we start about the parallel lines. Now here, two lines in a plane that do not meet at any point are called parallel lines, or we can write the another definition: if perpendicular distance between two lines are same at any point called parallel lines. See, two lines in a plane that do not meet at any point are called parallel lines, or another definition I have given, if perpendicular distance between two lines are same at any point called parallel lines. Let us take the example. Now see, this is the example. This is the example of the parallel lines. Now see, two lines in a plane that do not meet at them. Now line, one is AB, other line I have taken, that is a CD. If the AB and CD, if both are extended, and then the line AB and CD both do not meet at any point, then these two lines are called the parallel lines. We can take the example, that is track of the straight track of a rail ko jo patri huncha, now track, now in a straight, then these two are the parallel, that means distance, see, perpendicular distance between two lines. Now suppose here is a and perpendicular, see, perpendicular, here is a perpendicular. Suppose this is a 2 cm, it must be 2 cm, it must be 2 cm, it must be 2 cm. That means the distance between these two lines are same here also, there also, there also, there also. That's why AB and CD are called parallel lines. And we can write here AB parallel to CD, or we can write, this is a sign, AB parallel to CD. We can take another example. Suppose here is a line, here is a PQ, and the another line is here ST. If the distance between or these two lines do not intersect each other, if the PQ and the ST infinitely, if they were extended, then if these two lines do not intersect, do not meet, or the distance, you can see the perpendicular distance between these two lines are equal or same at any point, then these two lines are called parallel lines. Okay, and here we can write PQ parallel to ST, and this is a sign PQ parallel to ST. Here AB parallel to CD, we can write. Now lines are here, perpendicular lines. So now let's see how we define and what is the meaning of perpendicular lines. Now here perpendicular lines if two lines meet or intersect at angle of 90 degree, or you can say right angle, are called perpendicular lines. Example is here. Suppose here is a AB and is here CD. If CD and AB intersect each other, see each other at angle of, that means CD and AB, and between these two lines is angle of 90 degree, then these two lines are called perpendicular lines. And the symbol is here CD. We can write CD perpendicular to AB, or we can write CD perpendicular to AB. Is clear? Now we can take another example. Suppose here is a x dash, y and y dash, and this x axis and y axis, these two are intersecting each other at the point A, or at the angle of 90 degree, then xy, or we can say x axis and y axis are perpendicular to each other. That means x dash perpendicular to y dash, and y dash is perpendicular to what is the x dash, and these two are also called, that is a mutually perpendicular lines. So this is the meaning of perpendicular. Perpendicular means lumb, parallel means what is the samanantar. So is it clear about the perpendicular and parallel? So now I like to review, that means I like to remind you here today what we have learned. So now one by one, what I have taught today and what you have learned, so let us recap it. Now today I have taught you, suppose I have cleaned the whole board. Now what I have taught today, number one, I have taught about the geometry and basic concept of geometry. This is for class 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Then first we have learned about the, what is the geometry, and geometry means what is the geo plus what is the metron, and geometry, geo means what is the land or earth, and metron means what is the measurement. And second, what I have taught you about the Euclid. Who is Euclid? He is called, that is the father of geometry. Second, I have taught this. And the third, I have taught you definition of geometry. Definition of geometry. And number four, I have taught, that is the definition of point. Number five, I have taught concept or definition of line. Number six, today I have taught you line, that is a, I have taught, that is a no A B no ending points. Number 6 I have taught you about the ray that means one ending point. Number 7 I have taught you line segment. This is the AB, two ending points. Number 8 I have taught you today about the parallel lines. AB and CD, and we can write AB parallel CD. And last one I have taught today, number 9, perpendicular lines and the AB, here is the CD, that means AP perpendicular to CD because here is the angle of how much degree? 90 degree. So today I like to stop here and tomorrow we'll start the types of the angle, that means what is the definition or meaning of the angle and about the acute angle, right angle, obtuse angle, straight angle, reflex angle, complete angle will start tomorrow. So have a nice day. Thank you very much, all my dear students.